There we go.
Do you want two lions? We could have two lions talking to each other. Who do you want him to play the drums with?
And then we can add in the sound of the drums.
Yago Hahi. My English name is Olivia. I'm Oneida, and my clan is Turtle Clan. I grew up right on the Oneida Reservation in the Green Bay area of Wisconsin. I also work at Google. I was really interested in technology from a young age, so I studied science and technology in society. I'm really passionate about what technology can do for many different communities. This week, we are at the Indian Community School of Milwaukee, and we are facilitating some computer science first classes to teach kids in a really fun way how to code.
Special announcements for today, students and staff. We are about to kick off our October 12th PBIS kickoff event. Soar like an eagle, the ICS way, and have a great day.
So the Indian Community School started around 1969, and it really started under efforts in Milwaukee County to have students be able to culturally identify with themselves, know their history, know their culture, speak their languages.
Napuakan,
Asachikau.
We have over 20 different tribes represented. Part of the mission of the school, K-4 through 8th grade, was really culture at the center of everything that we do. You know, we have a multifaceted mission. One is for sure to strengthen cultural identity, but it's also to make sure that our students prepare to be problem solvers in an ever-changing world.
Siguli Swagwek, Yagu Hahiu Niyun Gets Oneota Aga Ni'i. That means, hello everyone. My name is Olivia. My Oneida name is Yago Hahi. I'm from the Oneida Nation, Wisconsin. I'm also from Google. This is my colleague Anne, who will be facilitating today's session on CS First. So we're working with Computer Science First, CS First, Be Internet Awesome, and Google Expeditions.
CS First is a computer programming club. So today we're going to do the very first activity along the theme of storytelling.
When you see them using like some of these Google programs, they figure it out, just like they would a video game at home or anything like that. They want to know how to do it, and they will troubleshoot it. They will problem solve it. You know, I can't imagine that my students would have that same type of engagement on a math worksheet.
Marcus, can you tell us something about your video?
It's two dogs meeting in the park, and they're talking to each other.
Awesome. I love how you noticed the dog barking on top of the translation.
I like the fact that everybody didn't know what to do, so we like worked together basically on what to do.
So within our own community, we have a whole group of parents that have not received training on using the internet appropriately. So we're trying to make sure that our students, they don't miss out on that opportunity.
That's pretty cool. Perfect.
Every single student that I saw in the room was engaged in what they were doing, 100%, which isn't, you know, that's not always gonna happen. And when I stopped in a class today, you couldn't hear anything.
In Indian country, it is a well-known phrase that as Native people, we walk in two worlds and have to succeed in both.
My name is Audrey Williams. I'm a mother of four. My son is Martin Williams. He's a student here. He's in sixth grade. Like, I instantly knew, like, he's gonna be someone and something awesome.
I like to sing, dance, go to powwows.
I think he's most connected to, like, the cultural stuff that we do. It's more of a natural feeling for him. He was, like, humming ceremony songs at the age of one. I just feel lucky as a mom to have my kids be excited about their culture. You know, I want to build that foundation.
I didn't have that much technology, I'd say, in my education growing up. It's something that other communities might just grow up with as a normal given. And I think that isn't necessarily the case in a lot of Native communities. I really see technology and education as the way to bring those two worlds together and to enable people to live in both worlds, because that's how I've been able to do it.
I want him to have the language and traditions and like combine it with technology and teach people.
My favorite thing for computers is to search up words in Ojibwe and to search up like videos of like dancing.
Just to see him so excited. He wants to learn so much. Like, as a parent, that's like the best thing in the world. He'll have all these tools like technology to share that. I think he can have a strong career in stuff he does naturally. Because I know the world that he's going into. Like, as soon as he leaves here, I want to prepare him as much as I can for the world.
For me, technology, it's our next tree or our next copper. It's something that we can use to help others.
I think it's really important that we provide access and that we use these tools on our own terms and within our own values.
It'll just make the culture richer, you know, and technology can do that. Google can do that.
Native students are then primed to do really cool things with technology. I think they can bring their unique backgrounds and their unique mindsets and values